As a select distribution partner of X12, the PilotFish EDI Console now offers a suite of productivity-boosting features that strip away the technical complexity of parsing, validating, mapping, and producing EDI X12 files. Over the next several minutes, you'll see these new capabilities in action. This is the EDI Console. It's an integrated development environment for building, testing, deploying, and maintaining integration interfaces. When you first open the EDI Console, you're shown this route file management dialog. Up at the top, you have your currently selected working directory. You can think of this as your project folder. And then in this table, you can see all the routes, all the individual workflows composing your interface.
Our interface is composed of these three routes. The first, ASC X12 837 claims processing, receives AS03 messages, converts them to XML, validates them, and maps their contents to a database. The second, 999 acknowledgement creation, generates an X12 acknowledgement. And last, the EDI transaction forking demonstrates handling batches and high volumes of X12 transactions. We'll start by opening up our first route here.
Now that our first route is open, we can see the main EDI console screen featuring our assembly line approach to building interfaces. This assembly line approach allows you to quickly and easily connect any system to any other system, regardless of the format or protocol between them. Now, in the main EDI console screen, on the left-hand side, you have rows representing sources and rows representing targets. You would start by adding however many sources and however many targets were necessary to describe your interface. You then move left to right through our assembly line approach, configuring each stage. Your first stage is the source system. This is a place to provide a name and optionally an icon for what it is you're connecting to, typically describing the format or the name of the system. The first functional stage is the listener. Now at the listener stage, you're going to choose a listener type from this dropdown or this dialog here. Now there are a number of ways to send or receive data: database, email, FTP, HTTP, directories, and so on. Generally, if you can think of a way to send or receive data, there's a listener available. So simply choose the listener, provide some configuration, and now it's ready to pick up messages and send them through the system. Those messages will move left to right through each of the stages you configure, generally in the same order you've configured them. The first set of stages that a message goes through are processors. Now, processors perform high-level operations on data, typically things like decryption, decompression, character conversion, and so on. In this particular route, after we've received our message, we're assuming it's a zip file, so we're going to decompress it, and then we're going to decrypt it. Each source system then has its own source transform associated with it. Now, the job of the source transform is to take whatever that particular source system gave you and convert it to a common representation that's understood by the rest of the route. This is a two-stage process. The first part is a transformation module to take any non-XML format and convert it to XML. And then optionally, there's a logical transformation from that XML that's produced into whatever we consider our route canonical. We'll now take a look at the EDI transformer. This component automatically converts EDI X12 messages to XML, as well as performing validation along the way. There are a number of useful features configured in these tabs. We'll start with the transform to XML. The first option allows us to specify EDI table data for use in validation, naming, and structuring of data. Here we can provide a location for those table files. Next, we can enable code definitions to get more contextual information whenever EDI code values are used, such as in an REF or NM1 segment. The friendly naming feature provides friendly, human-readable names and meanings in the created XML. It's very useful, allowing you to easily understand EDI messages. We also have built-in support for automatically performing SNP validations, including type 1, integrity testing, type 2, requirement testing, type 3, balancing, for example, adding up all the values for claims, and then specifying how you want those validation results to be produced. Once we've configured our EDI transformer, it's ready to convert X12 data to XML. Now I'll take a look at mapping X12 data to or from another format using the Datamapper. Here, we have a mapping from X12 to a relational database. We'll take a look at it in the Datamapper by clicking here.
Our Datamapper is a three-pane mapping tool. The left-hand side here is our source format. In this case, this is the EDI X12 we're mapping from. Our right-hand side is our target format. In this case, it's what we call SQL XML. And in the center is a tree representing our actual mapping logic. Now, use this tool by dragging and dropping from the left and right-hand panels into the center tree. So everything's completely graphical, drag and drop. First thing we're going to do when we get in here is push this button here to enable friendly names. So this is going to tell us, for example, that a loop 2000A is our billing provider loop. If we expand this, we'll see, for example, that the loop 2010AA is the billing provider name loop with the various segments for naming the billing provider. So here we can see the friendly naming providing us all the information we need to be able to map from this. If we can understand what the billing provider first name is, then you don't need to know that it's under a loop 2010AA, NM1, NM104. You can map to and from EDI without really understanding the intricacies of the format itself. Now the right-hand side is SQL XML. This is an XML representation of SQL statements. So what we're going to be doing is an insert into this table using this column, and this column, and this column, and so on. So we've got those columns represented here, drag and drop from the right, and then we populate them from the left. So what we'll do is we'll show that. We're going to take this name field, right-click, and delete. To map it, we simply drag and drop it from the right onto EDI billing provider, and then go on and provide a name. So here I could just say, well, I want to use the first name. And we'll drag and drop that here, and it's going to create the logic necessary to accomplish that mapping. That's all you do. Drag and drop from left and right, and you can map anything to or from EDI. Now underneath, this mapping is producing W3C compliant XSLT, which you can always view by dropping this XSLT view down here. Now this is a fully featured editor. It'll allow you to make changes. Any changes you make will show up in the mapping, and vice versa. But the only reason we show this is to note it's a W3C standard transformation language. There's nothing proprietary. There's nothing tying mapping specific to our tool. So the drag and drop is going to produce this, and then you also have the ability to do testing. You can give it a sample file, push a button, and see your output. We have a debugger to allow you to do that step by step, and a number of other features that make it kind of easy to do mappings. So you can search and sort through the source and target format, you can add notes for collaboration, and anywhere there's documentation in the EDI standard, those are down here available in these tabs, along with further information or sample files, or for coded values, what the coded value in this particular case is. So now that we've quickly walked through our mapping, we'll return to our main EDI console screen and perform some testing. So I'm going to go to route, switch to testing mode, and then we're going to run the test from a certain point. We're going to choose a source transform, provide a sample file, and then we'll hit execute test. We'll see our transform run across. We can now view the original EDI message, shown here, broken into different lines for legibility. We can see the XML representation of that with our friendly naming, so we can see, for example, that an NM101 is an entity identifier code and some information about the code definition, telling us this 41 represents a submitter. So this shows our XML, the human readable friendly name option enabled. You can see, as long as you can understand what a subscriber first name is, or what healthcare code information is, you can work with this. Our transform over here to our database produced this, a very small segment of some SQL XML. So we're going to do an insert into this table. This column will get the value Ben Kildare's service, address, city, state, zip, and so on. So what we'll quickly do is just take a look at our database and see what the contents within there look like. So here we have our database shown in a browser. It's a simple embedded H2 database with a single table. We'll run a basic query, hit run, and we can see the insert from our latest test here with the name, address, city, state, zip as it came from the EDI. Now for this interface, we do a few other things too. In addition to inserting into a database, we also call another route that is used for generating the acknowledgement, generating some EDI that's going to be sent back to the original caller. Here's that route here. We have a listener here that's going to accept the data from the first route. And here we see an EDI transformer being used on the target side. For this, all we really need to do is specify if we want inlines for human legibility and the different delimiters we're going to use in the produced EDI. That's it. Next step is just going to be going to the transport and specifying how we want to send that out. In this case, we're just going to write out a file, but if you can think of a way to send or receive data, there's probably a transport available for it. Now the last route we want to take a look at is our EDI transaction forking. This demonstrates the handling of large transaction sets, either in batches or in parallel. Now at the source transform, we've specified in this forking tab this EDI transaction forking module. And what this is going to do is enable you to take an EDI message containing maybe one, dozens, hundreds, thousands, or even millions of EDI messages and break them into discrete batches according to some delimiter here. They'll then operate in parallel where they can be reordered and sent along to your final destination system. So this has been a relatively quick walkthrough of some of the EDI features and functionality that are now in the EDI console. We recommend downloading a trial of the EDI console and taking a look at this, as well as viewing any of our other videos available on our website. Thank you.